This video is all about file sharing. Sharing means sending as a link. As far as possible, avoid attachments. So files are stored on OneDrive. If you see it on browser, you will see which file is private and which file is shared. There is a share button on browser. Similar share button is available in File Explorer in Windows. If you right click on a file, you still get the same sharing button. But if the file is already open, say in Word or Excel or PowerPoint, then top right corner, there is a share button. Similar thing is available on mobile app as well. All of them open the same dialog. The first thing to notice is this file shared already? If you see a lock icon here, that means it is not shared. But whom are you giving the permission to? You can give their names here. Or if you click on the wheel, there are more options. This means anyone with a link. This means people in your company. This means people who already have access to that file or that folder. You're not giving access to any new person. Most commonly, we use this. So choose people, apply. So now I have added my assistant email ID there. Having done all this, if you want, you can put a message here. If you have Copilot and then browser version of Word, it will even allow you to create summary for that file. Otherwise, you can just put a message yourself. When you click on send, a mail is going to go through your Outlook and that email will have the link to the file. If you would prefer to copy the link and send it to the other party in chat or some other mechanism, use this option. In some other cases, you want the full featured Outlook email option. Click on the three dots here and say send link in Outlook. That'll open Outlook, create a new mail and put the link in that email automatically. The mail will open on browser. You get all the features of Outlook. The best of both worlds. And the last situation is if I don't want to share it as a link for legal reasons, sometimes it's a payslip, it's an RFP. I cannot send it as a link. It is mandatory that I send it as an attachment. In that case, what do? Click again, say send a copy. And now it is again going to open a Outlook mail message with a proper attachment added. So I have shared this file and given edit permission to someone. What if I want to give read-only permission to some other people? No problem. Go to the share button again. This time I'm sending it to my salesperson, changing the permission from edit to view and then send. So if you have different types of permissions you want to give to different people, you'll have to come to this dialog multiple times. Earlier, this was shown as a lock. Now we can see the profile pictures of each person with whom this file is shared. And if I want to modify the way sharing is done, click on that area and now you can customize it further. It tells you that there are three people who can see this file, no groups, and there is one link. So if you want to remove this permission, you can delete the link itself, or if you want to keep it, but you want to change the permission, go to the link, click on the sprocket or wheel, and here I can change from edit to say read only. You don't have to send the link again. The same link will change its behavior. And how do you stop sharing? Simple. There's a direct button here, stop sharing. It doesn't matter how many people you have shared the file with. One click will get rid of everything. So that is how you share files more effectively. If you found this useful, share it with as many people as you can. Subscribe, click the bell icon, like, comment, ask questions. In fact, few seconds back, I reached 60,000 subscribers, which is great. But think about it, 1 billion people use Office tools and most of them will benefit from this knowledge. So that's why you sharing it with others is very, very important for everyone's efficiency. I have many other videos which are related to OneDrive best practices. Have a look at them. That's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.